Welcome to Modular Classroom, an artificial intelligence series. Today we are going to see planning. In planning, we are going to see about goal stack planning. So what is meant by goal stack planning? It is one of the most important planning algorithm which is used by STRIPS. STRIPS is the Standard Institute's algorithm that what we saw in the previous video. Here, the stack is used in an algorithm to hold the action and satisfy the goal. A knowledge base is used to hold the current state and the action. So that is a database acting. And goal stack is similar to a node in a search tree where the branches are created if there is a choice of an action. Likewise, the goal in the stack will be used for examination. Goal stack technique was developed for solving compound goals. This was the approach as said used by STRIPS. Here, the problem solver makes use of a single stack that contains both goals and operators that have been proposed to satisfy those goals. Also, a database that describes the current situation for each operators used. The operators are add, delete, and precondition. These what we saw in the previous video. The goal stack planning method attacks problems involving conjoined, that is compound goals, by solving the goals one at a time in order. The plan generated by this method contains a sequence of operator for attaining the first goal, followed by a complete sequence for the second goal, etc. until the goal is being empty. This is what the steps of the algorithm. Finally, the goal that is in the top of the stack will be explored. This process continues until the goal stack is empty. Now, we will see an example for the goal stack planning with a very simple blocks built problem. This is a start state given and we have to come to this goal state. The start state given is on A, B, on table A, on table C and on table D and the robot arm is empty. From this start state, we have to go to this goal state on C, A, on B, D and on table of A and on table of D. Here, the problem is separated into four sub-problems. That is, a goal state problem is being divided into four sub-problems on C of A, on B of D, on table A, on table D. Two sub-problems on table of A and on table of D is already true in the initial state itself. See here, A is on the table and D is on the table. That is given in the goal state also. So now we have to concentrate only on the two sub-problems or sub-goals on C, A and on D and you have to proceed with that. So there are two alternatives, that is a two sub-goals on C, A and B, D to come into this goal state. So alternative one on C, A, on B, D and combine it into one goal. The second alternative is that first you're going to solve on B, D, next on C, A and final goal is being achieved. Here OTAD means nothing but on table A and on table D. The method is to explore the first node on the stack, that is on the top goal. Next, if a sequence of operators is found that satisfies this goal, it will be removed and the next goal will be attempted. This continues until the goal state is empty. Just listen, friends, this is the point where the goal state is going to work. With this 3 point only, the whole example is going to achieve into this goal state. There's nothing, only this 3 point. The first node will be taken for exploration and if it satisfies the goal state, it will be removed and the next goal will be attempted. Until the goal state is empty, we're going to do this. So now we will take into the first alternative, that is on C, A, on B, D and on the first goal is this. Here the first goal itself on C, A is false. To make this particular on C, A goal to be true, we have to apply this operation stack of C, A which replaces on C, A giving because this stack C, A's precondition list is on that is on C, A's precondition list is stack C, A that you have to apply once so that only you can place this on C, A to become true. But to apply this stack C, A, you must satisfy a precondition. For that, you need two preconditions of stack, that is clear of A and holding of C. So you are going to replace with this, see clearly this stack C, A condition is being replaced with its precondition clear of A and holding of C. Here all this is a goal stack that will be retained from the previous. Here these goals will be gobbled down in the stack. Now the top of the stack will be the current state that you're going to solve. So clear of A, holding of C, these are the two preconditions of the stack that you want to make it true to achieve the stack C, A. The stack C, A, if it becomes true only, you can able to achieve that on C, A. So here the top goals, clear of A, is false. See here, friends. Clear of A, here just this particular option you have to taken to become false. As clear of A is false, here it is already having one particular block B is within it. So you cannot say now it is true. So this condition at this point are becoming false. So only the operator that makes to become true is you have to unstack B, A. So only the clear of A will become false. So here what I'm going to do is it produces another new goal stack that is on B, A. Unstack means you have to place this. These are the preconditions of unstack. So you're replacing with this because the precondition of unstack B, A is on B, A, clear of B and arm empty. You're replacing with these three preconditions of unstack B, A to achieve this clear of A. This clear of A is nothing but it is a precondition of stack. As these three top goals are true, they can be popped up from the stack. This will be replaced. The fourth goal is a combined goal. So these four goals will be now popped up from the stack. Now your remaining goal is unstack holding clear of A. That's it. Now your current point. This gives you first node in the database is like this. The goal stack now is holding of C, clear of A, and holding of C, stack of C, A on B, D here and all. So now the first goal on the stack is holding of C. To achieve this holding of C, you need the two operators, pickup of C and unstack C, A. By using these two operators, you can achieve holding of C. Holding of C to make it true, you can do one first option is pickup of C. So the condition holding of C will become true. Rather than a robot or a kai when the C block pick panikichina, holding of C is the true wire. And at the same time, another operation you can apply unstack C, X here. X is an unspecified block. We cannot determine in which particular block this X belongs to. So you have another sub problem. So this takes two alternatives. This two alternative has been taken to solve, and here in second alternative, the goal stack contains a variable x appearing in three places, here one, here two, and here three. So these three places, any block can be substituted for x, but it match these x. So binding of the value should be recorded. So it is a tedious task for that we can easily take on that particular option pickup, but here we are again taking alternative 2 because it is a pickup C is better, as I said in the previous slide, pickup C is better, but to now we are taking alternative 2 because we have to first to stack it, so waste of effort. For that, the precondition of stack is holding of C. This is to be achieved by applying unstack, which required to apply stack so that the precondition would be satisfied. Here comes back to the original goal. So now if block C has been on another block, it have been satisfied immediately. So no need to stack, and this path leads to a good solution. Now choose alternative 1 pickup. Here the top goal is on table of C is true, so pop it. Next goal is clear of C, it is also true, so pop it. Third goal is arm empty, it is false because holding of B is true. Since this is true, this cannot be false. So to make arm empty true, you have to apply two operators. One is stack B, X and put turn of B. So block B must be on block D. So choose stack B, D. Substituting X, D in the place of X, that is binding D to X. This makes the goal state. This is the goal state. So the precondition of stack B, D, clear of D and holding of D are both true, which produces the worst model. This is a particular state. This means pickup of C and then stack of C, is true. So again, now choosing the alternative to the result. Now we are coming into the most initial state, the two alternatives. We are coming to the second alternative. Here also same process repeats. So the final plan that you derive with the problem solver is this unstack B, A, stack B, D, pickup of C, stack C, A. So these are the four main plan you are deriving and you are coming into the goal state. In this example, the heuristic function is applied to guide the search process so an unprofitable path could be deducted and interacted among the goals to produce a good overall solution. That's all, my dear friends, about goal stack planning. So these are the final steps.